Do you want
say whatever I want. It's my day, Anders. It's my day. Well, it's just, I mean, the main thing here is that VP should be able to control the... They should just have the edge on Cobblestone. They're not a weak team on Cobblestone by any stretch, and if Complexity just don't play the map, they may have some rudimentary strats, but the timings, all that sort of fine-tuning, they aren't going to have versus a team that clearly has more experience on the map than they do. So, really, you know, with VP fired up and ready to go after Overpass, it should be pretty brutal here for Complexity.
Oh, Snacks actually almost caught reloading then, but Neo Pasha and then Snacks again. They're all headshots so far, and Whitmer going to be the only one to have any say in this round, taking out by Ali, and that's obviously not going to be enough. So Virtus Pro off to a decent start on the CT side of Cobblestone. And you know, the panelists were talking about the addition of that stairwell, which I can tell still hasn't really been updated on the main map. But either way, I'm also worried about it. I'm not sure that it really does favor the CT side.
Yeah, I mean, we've just seen some teams already take that into account and just throw a Molotov there. And they're like, right, cleared it out with the Molotov. I think it's for later on in the round. If Complexity try to slow play it and they don't go for the rush, then maybe there's more chance to just kind of peek up there with a single man and get the info. But right now, Complexity, man, they aren't wasting any time whatsoever. They charge straight out onto the B side. It's a bit of a whirlwind over here. Two players going down for each team, and there's the third. Sanks finds the headshot on Neo. Surreal comes out of connector and drops Bialy. And while Snacks, it's not looking good for him, he's down to 1 HP already.
Really great pacing in a round like this for Complexity, and we've seen it time and again from multiple teams how powerful that Tech Nine rush really can be. Snacks going to be going down. Sanks picking up a double Surreal with a double, and Complexity immediately stealing the game back from Virtus Pro. So really good job there. Going to tie it up at 1-1 and moving into the third round. We'll see if VP have anything in store here. They've already bought up with the armor, pistols, and even a max 7 on Pasha.
Ooh. But Snacks isn't fully committing to this. Look at this. Snacks is in only halfway. He's gone for the Deagle, he's gone for a Flash, but he's actually managing his economy. So that makes me think that whatever the outcome here, Snacks is going to be trying to go for that primary op. So that's interesting. A little bit of an adjustment made there from VP, although we did see the same thing on Overpass from Snacks. He was opping there as well. So it looks like on Cobblestone, he wants to go back to more of that. Molotovs, everything coming down into drop. Bialy just barely makes it out in time. His teammate playing from connector, Taz, gets flashed as well. So he's on his own here. Not a whole lot of info for Virtus Pro to go off of, although Pasha picks up one, could go for a second, but Sanks with the pre-fire is going to catch him.
Good quick trade there. One for one. Taz, Bialy, and Neo still alive on the B-bomb side, but Snacks moving up from behind like this. Timing is pretty much everything right now. He's going to be hiding there. I'm not sure that's a great spot. Def still has a decent chance of actually ending up checking there, and there it is. MP9 just right to the face. Going to end up being the end of Snacks. Android looking for a kill on Neo. He's going to find it as well. So really successful round coming out of Complexity so far here, and Taz, last man left, not going to make it work. Complexity with 2-0.
2-0 and actually showing some variety, playing off the fact that, wait a second, we don't actually know what's waiting for us over here on the B site. Let's work our way back towards A and wind up there. I do like it from VP. You know, they go for the buy. That's fine, right? Because they do actually get one kill. So Pasha, because he got that one kill with the shotgun, he's going to go ahead and reinvest in a CZ-75. So he'll be able to do a little bit more damage this round, perhaps, playing from Plateau. Lots of chances to get that little machine pistol into play. But yeah, Complexity right now, it seems like, again, straight towards B, straight towards that drop Plateau pressure. And Whitmer looks like the man to take point here in this sort of scenario. Still, Bialy, he's on those stairs, so we have to see if that comes into play. But no, there's the Molotov to force him out into the open.
Yeah, just not successful at all. And it seems like almost all teams figure that out very quickly, that sort of is the way to handle it. So Snacks and Taz left without the armor. Android actually going to catch Snacks there. And Taz is on a bit of a weird mission. It's just,
ooh. Well, that's pleasant.
Find a mag 7. If he could find a kill with it as well, that would be interesting. But Snacks is obviously ready for the AWP coming up into the fifth round, so we'll see if that's going to be a real thing. He's not got that much for it, but he's got, I think, just enough.
Yeah, he'll have it. It's just, where is he going to decide to take it? Because right now, Complexity, they've gone B every single round, so does he just go and set up in Chicken Coop with it, which is one of the more common spots to use that AWP from? You either play, usually you play from the B site itself, kind of dancing on the pillar, or you're playing from Chicken Coop and just looking towards Plateau. So likelihood of him actually heading over there with it pretty high, unless Complexity. I mean, this is where the mind games start to come in, right? Where it's like Complexity are probably thinking, right, okay, now they're going to buy. Maybe it's time to go towards A long, put a little pressure over there, try and test that A defense, because we have gone B quite a bit.
Ooh, and actually, Snacks doesn't actually buy the AWP. I thought maybe he would have. Instead, he goes for armor and a lot of grenades and everything else. So, a bit interesting. He would have had enough money for it, although it would have been without the armor. But we see people do that routinely. So, I'm wondering if that was like a team decision coming in there saying, wait a minute, let's not even try and do that. Snacks and Taz are going to be playing towards the middle of the map. Some early grenades being exchanged here, but no one dying yet.
Mm-hmm. And Complexity do make their way over towards that A site. They've gone aggressive B so many times now, they're like, right, all right, let's go ahead and take a look, try and feel out how this A site defense looks and what Verspro are actually putting over here for us. And so far, VP, they've kind of gone for that default sort of hold, not really stacking on B, having two players over here towards A, and one of them crouched in danger. That's Taz. He's going to chase Def away. But eventually, you know, seeing, right, okay, so they actually do have a strong setup for us waiting. Let's go ahead, head back towards that site we've had so much success at. We've shown ourselves over on A, so that means that VP have to be honest. And they, I mean, so honest that, in fact, they've rotated Neo over there to support on A.
Yeah, but now they're going to be boosting Snacks up, and he's on the sort of the wall over there. You got to wonder if they would feel confident enough. I don't know why they have three people here, especially with this boost. Mm-hmm. It seems like a wild overcommitment right now. That could very well backfire here. Complexity could be heading for a fourth round. It's just two people defending on B, and the attack is going to be coming in any second. Surreal making a bit of noise. Flashbang around the corner. Pasha close with the max 7. Still three shells left here, not hitting. There's the one, and a second one as well. Two great kills coming through, but now he's going to be out of it. Just doesn't have enough time to reload either. By Ali looking for a kill. Could have been either one, but he will at least have evoked enough time for the rest of VP to show up here. Right now it's a 2-on-3, and Sax trying to make his way out. He knows there's a guy by the statue, has to try and find the kill on him first. Bomb plot needs to happen, there's 10 seconds left.
Yeah, there's just no time, they have to make the play. Sanx is going to step up, pick up the kill, but Neo denies the bomb plant. That pretty much snuffs the round right here, unless Sanx can find the... No, he's not even going to have the time. 3 seconds left in the round means not enough time to actually get the bomb down. And Taz will find the kill on Sanx. Not sure if that actually happened after the clock went down or not. It looks like it did, because he's definitely lower on money than the rest of his teammates. But the main difference here is just that if it isn't for Pasha and the hero play, this has to be a Complexity round. This is looking so good. Although Neo had rotated back by the time the push actually began on Plateau for Complexity. What I think is going through Virtus.pro's mind right now, though, is that on Overpass and here on Cobble, we haven't really seen anything subtle coming off of Complexity. No real fakes or anything like that, mind games, right? Complexity show themselves, and they in general try and push onto the site. So VP, they're just like, right, so they showed themselves at A. We're just going to actually keep the defense over here for quite some time because likelihood of them going A pretty high at this point, right?
Yeah, and I can follow that insofar as they would just stick with two people on the A-bomb side, but having the third man there just seems like way too much, especially when you also have one of them boosted up in a sort of a rare position. So I don't know. I'm not sure I follow entirely, but it did work out in the end, and we are looking at a 2-3 scoreline here. They've managed to take over control of long Complexity without really any fight. Just, I think, a little bit of Molotov damage on the Sanx, but that's about it. So we'll see if they could do something with it now. Again, they do have that very strong setup, but this time it makes a lot more sense because they have Pasha, who is sort of sneaking in towards the B long area. He's got a lot of information just playing around there.
Yeah, he's on. Yeah, exactly. He's just peeking on a plateau and not seeing anybody there. And Taz is also holding up close to danger, and he's heard at least two people stepping around in the halls. And so that kind of tends to make you think, right, at least there is a bit of presence over here. It's definitely quieted down, but there's the flash, not a perfect one, and Taz not going to be able to get anything out of it. Gets overrun completely. So man advantage now for Complexity, pressing onto the A site. 35 seconds left in this round. The anti-flash is coming out here from Virtus.pro, trying to buy some time for the rotation to come through, and that is going to be Bialy up on the balcony. He drops down. Not sure if Android heard that, and Android, he doesn't have to worry about it. He snuffs Bialy, and Def is there to pick up Snacks on the site.
Great round coming out of Complexity. They're so excited. They will be losing Sanks and Android, but Ritma coming up from behind. It's now just Neo left here. 1 versus 3. That grenade not going to tag up anybody. And Complexity, you just play it nice and slow at the end of this round. That's going to reset so much of Virtus.pro's economy. In fact, they won't be able to buy anything. Just save this rifle and get out. And a really good round coming in. I was actually going to criticize Complexity because I thought it was a bit weird. They put up a lot of smokes to cover off sort of the main entrances, And then they slowed down a lot. They really waited a long time when Snax was on the bomb site. So in a sense, Snax is hoping they'll be slow because that will buy time for his teammates to get there. So I was worried that Complexity was sort of missing the timing window and just being too slow, but it worked out. And obviously that's the most important thing.
That was a sick shot from Def. And I think that's the real, the linchpin kind of play there is that Taz needs to trade one for one in that sort of scenario. So Def just denying him outright, that was a big difference maker because then Complexity have that man advantage. So long as they keep charging up onto the site, no fear, if they're trading effectively, they'll continue to have that man advantage until eventually they win the round, right? So the fact that Taz isn't able to just do some damage there from that position, he was in a bit of an off angle, he really should have been able to pick up a one kill. But Def, you know, takes that away from VP and Complexity now. They're looking fantastic. They have the rifles, VP back on pistols. And again, Complexity, early pressure here towards B.
Very, very good stuff. You can see the Snax is ready to walk in behind them again, but Surreal is seeing that coming while the rest are pushing this B bomb site. Neo there, but he's only going to get the one kill. That was Snax with the flank already down, and Pasha to fall as well. So very good teamwork coming out of Complexity and some heads-up play. You know, they're really trying to, just trying to see what Virtus.pro might do, and they're doing a pretty good job predicting it. Bayali looking for a shot with a Deagle. That's going to be the headshot to take down Android. A little bit painful. Don't want to lose too many guns here. They should be able to take care of Bayali.
It's surprising to see Pasha wait so long, hesitate to go for the trade kill. When Neo dies, I mean, Pasha's close enough to hear the headshot as well, so it's just like, you know, he should be going for the peak instantly. Instead, he hesitated long enough for Complexity to catch their breath. So it's just the small details here. But Complexity, man, they're edging out a pretty solid advantage right now. 5-2 for them on their T side. They've shattered Virtus.pro's economy. It's another round of eco here for VP. And Complexity, I mean, they're starting to get a little bit of a bank to work with. Not a huge one. I mean, Whitmer's the richest, but between Whitmer and Surreal, they have two guys sitting above 5,000. So this is pretty solid here for Complexity. They should be feeling pretty confident.
We'll see. Not really a lot of investment for Virtus.pro into a round like this one, and you can't blame them for it. I mean, at this point, you got to think they'll upgrade to the AWP. They kind of skipped out on it earlier, but I think with a save like this, because the base economy is not that bad, I think at least one AWP. Maybe they could even go for two if they were feeling adventurous. And Bayali already out of the round.
Yeah, I wonder, I mean, they do have the capability, right? Well, it's been a long time since Pasha has been picking up the op consistently for VP. But I mean, between Neo and Snax, you've got two capable offers there. So we'll see if VP, if that's going to be their call, their play, because you put one on each site and then play off of that. Neo is going to be setting it up, perhaps. Pasha gets roasted, forced out into the open. Neo crouching on those new stairs. And we'll see if he finds his opportunity to get in here and try and find one. He is going to be able to pick up one kill, and Snax is there to jump on Whitmer. But it's still a man advantage here for Complexity, and they should have every advantage to just push onto the site at this point. Because Taz and Snax don't really have the best firepower to put a stop to it. Nice nade onto Snax. Well, Surreal will find Snax. Android takes out Taz, and that's a solid recovery for Complexity. After losing two players, they still kept the remaining three alive.
I love it. I love the energy. Basically, I think just a small point there. I think Widmer, when he jumps down, and he sort of swings left and he sees a player, but then he's also worried about getting shot in the back, so he swings back. And he should probably just have trusted that his teammates were going to take care of that and focused on the first target that he had. But that's like it's very hard to do that. It takes a lot of experience. You instinctively get a little bit frustrated. We do have the double AWP set up, and in fact, instead of Neo, it is Pasha picking up the second AWP. So that's very interesting. Snax already picking up the first kill there, taking down Def, and now they're pushing into the middle. Taz taking out one, dropping the bomb as well, and seeing that, it's going to be a 4-on-3, and Snax pushing close here. And that kind of a flick, going to be taken out Surreal. That's exactly the reason why Snax is a little bit scary with that AWP as well.
Yeah, brutal, and perfect on the timing as well. He realizes, wait, I've lost Taz. I'm pushed up aggressive in-house. I need to watch my flank, and he comes back right in time to catch out Surreal. So solid work there from Snax, and he is able to back off, take a bit more of a passive position on the site. He's got a teammate who's rotated in with him now as well. That's going to be Bialy holding by the wooden wall, basically. And so now, well, life gets a little bit difficult here for Complexity. They need to hope that VP are going to be the ones peeking out and giving them a chance to get back into this round with some free kills. But there shouldn't be. I mean, it just shouldn't happen right now. Snax is holding close. Bialy has got his back. And now there's even a third line of defense here. Bialy doesn't have to worry about his back. He's got his teammate rotated in. And Whitmer is going to be able to spot the man holding close. But Neo's there to get the kill. Swings wide. And just a very solid round altogether here for Virtus Pro. That double up, it pays off. Snax with two kills.
Yeah, definitely. And that start as well, because it's followed up with a, well, it's initiated with a flashbang, so they couldn't even easily return that kind of a fire. So, yeah, 6-3, a little bit working out for Virtus Pro. And again, they're playing on the less favored side. They don't need that much, I think. So Complexity, they can't feel safe and secure until they've closed out this round. They need to keep Virtus Pro very low here.
Need to keep Virtus Pro's economy in the dumpster, basically. Just constantly keep that pressure up. Double up is so expensive as a go-to strategy. Snax with a bit of a one-way smoke. He's just crouching on the edge, looking for somebody to get hungry and go for the peek over here at long, and he might be rewarded. Sanx is about to jump up there. This is going to pay off. Right on the edge, but Sanx, he's not going to give Snax a target to work with, and as the smoke clears, Snax is going to have to start thinking about backing off here.
Oh, Whitmer, I feel like it's just not been his game here on Cobblestone. A little bit rough start for him. He was trying to shoulder peek and maybe bait out that Shun. I think they just realized just in that very second that Pasha was there. So that's a very good kill to start off with. Now they're all setting up to drop right down on Neo, but that smoke goes up. They don't want to challenge it. You could tell they were ready for it. The timing off by just a second there. I kind of wish Pasha would shoot through the wall up here. You can hit people exactly where they're sitting. And shoot through that wall with the orb.
He doesn't know the wall bag. That would be brutal. But it does look like it's going to be into drop. Crossfire established and drop, however, so it's not going to be easy. Piali is there to back up Neo. Snax has already rotated over towards the B site as well. And it will be Complexity committing toward this B site. 30 seconds left on the clock for the push. And Neo holding close. We'll see if he can actually pick up one. They line up and he sprays down three. Beautiful work from Neo. That leaves Surreal alone, and Pasha will find him crouching. Two kills for Pasha, three for Neo. And a 4-6 scoreline now. Virtus Pro getting one round closer to tying things up.
That's a bit of a problem, obviously. That kind of round, a flawless one, is keeping these AWPs alive for a long time. I'm wondering if that, because the flashbang that Neo throws, it hits the wall and it bounces back in. I'm wondering if from their point of view, because they were right on the other side when that happened, if what, how they interpret that is actually that it's thrown from inside the bomb site and it sort of just bounces in, and maybe they think, oh, there's not going to be anyone close, because if he had been close, he would have thrown a pop flash, right, and it wouldn't have hit anything. So I think maybe the sound of it bouncing off the wall actually sort of cheated them a little bit here. Good start though, Whitmer and Surreal picking up a couple of shots, and again, it's the quick round into the B bomb site here, but it looks like they have been more or less locked down behind the box, and they don't have the bomb either. Neo picking up a triple again, this time looking for a 4 kill.
It's going to be Snax to deny him the pleasure, so that's a little unfortunate for Complexity, but it worked in the second round after the pistol. So Complexity, they're thinking, right, well, Tech Nines, a single flash, a single smoke, try and get in there quick. Unfortunately for them, their flank man, I mean, was it Sanx? Whoever was in drop got picked off really early by Bialy. And so it's just now VP can just fully focus on the guys on the site. They know where everybody is, and it just turns into a bit of a bloodbath. So 5-6, VP one round closer to tying it up here. And they're actually starting to get into the danger zone here, Anders. I mean, five rounds on CT side Cobble, it's respectable. If they get up to 6 or 7, light, it's just going to be so difficult here for Complexity to turn it around in that second half. But it's looking to me like Complexity, once again, I mean, they've only really gone to A site a couple times, and those times also have been like forced to go towards A site, right? Things have got nasty at B and they decide to try and rotate in. Seems like Complexity, again, really just want to focus on getting plateau control and rushing out onto the site. Perfect anti-flash there from Neo, and if he'd have picked up that kill on death, that would have been huge, but Pasha's there to trade. Now it's Complexity fully committed to the B site.
Yeah, Taz has also gone down, and that's obviously a big advantage here. Bialy gets a headshot on Surreal. It's still a 3-on-3. See if they can maybe find a way to break through here. They don't have the bomb plan yet. There's still a minute left, and Sanx is going to be taken out. Bialy and Pasha out of the open. Second kill coming through for Sanx, and maybe a bit too aggressive there. They just need to focus on the bomb plant and then holding Snax off of the bomb side. If they show themselves, there's definitely a round that Snax could try and clutch.
I heard the nice shout and clap, and it's perfect. Android peeks out at the perfect time to pick up that kill, and there you have the Complexity owner, in fact, Jason Lake. With the red tie. Didn't forget the red tie.
Someone who's been in Counter-Strike for more than just a little bit. Just, you know, a couple of years on his back with the game here. Nice of him to show up, and he is the second time he's been here in the league. He was here the opening week, very excited to see everything, so keeping an eye on things. Yeah, I mean, it wasn't even that long ago that there was really no North American events at all, right? And suddenly it's picked up, and it seems to be more and more happening. That's obviously very exciting. We got Snacks opening up this round and taking out Surreal. So not the best start possible, and we are back with the double up setup here for Virtus Pro at a 5-7 scoreline. I like the fact that they're all the time complexity keeping one person sort of covering any kind of a flank, because they realize that that's something that VP love doing.
No, exactly. I mean, this you have to realize that Europeans, they're always going to challenge you. They very rarely stay static on sites. They will try and come and push and look for an opening, and well, you have to watch your back, because you're going to get punished otherwise. Neo will catch out Death to start, but Sanks spots out Pasha getting greedy, standing up on the boxes on Plateau, and manages to clip him through the smoke. Still, Bialy steps in to drop and takes out Android, so they maintain control versus Pro. Still a two-man advantage here, and now a three-man advantage as Whitmer is now the last man alive. Hits a beautiful shot on Neo, but now it's still a three-on-one here.
Snack's going to be able to take him down. It looked like a flashy shot, but yeah, oh, that's a very exciting kill there. Think about how annoying that must be. He's so far in, he's so far committed as well to getting that kill, but he will get it. 6-7 being the scoreline now, and moving into the 14th round, we're back to a couple of pistols there. Nothing too exciting. I was wondering if they were going to go for Tech9 armor and try and see if they could get into B again.
Oh, yeah, there's going to be a change, actually. Instead of going towards B, they're going to go straight towards A long. Seems like they may have picked up on the fact that at least one of the ops is over here, so you can always try and rush down an AWP up close with the pistols. Worst case scenario, Snacks picks off one of your guys, and then you're able to just, you know, rush him, get onto the site, get the plant. But VP right now, they're in a catch-all kind of situation where they've got three guys over here towards A with two waiting in connector. Well, two on A, now three, and Pasha's still in connector. So it's going to be a very quick rotation here from Virtus Pro towards this A site. Bialy to pick up the first kill, and it's just all going to devolve from here. Sanks, the last man alive, in a blink of an eye, just gets completely smashed. Boom. Complexity. They just ran right into the blender.
Right, and one of the reasons why VP are able to put three men over at the A bomb site, which is normally considered a big risk, is the fact that Neo is sort of pushing up over on this side of the map, and he actually puts up a smoke here, which means anyone peeking in will probably think, oh, there's a smoke up, so they're defending on this side of the smoke, on the normal side, right? But Neo is on this side, and they have a lot of information about what's happening, so that's a very cool play. So putting three people on A when you have this guy pushed up is not really that much of a risk. I kind of like it. I think it's a cool variation, something that we rarely see on Cobblestone. And it's been one of the sort of main points of criticism that myself and others have made about this map, is it's hard to do that on the CT side. Pasha opening up here and taking down Android, but they're getting very quickly into the bomb side here. Whitmer getting a double kill before he eventually goes down and Pasha will fall. So full 2-on-2 here, trying to see if they could get in and defuse that bomb.
Snacks and Taz have a lot of utility to work with. Only problem is that Snacks has got that op, not always the best weapon to go for a retake with, unless somebody peeks. Like you can see him, he's just hoping right now that somebody playing Chicken Coop is going to peek out for him. And there's the incendiary that's kind of forced the man's hand, but he puts the shot through the edge of the pillar. Does he get the dunk nade? Yes, he does, but Death still survives with 7 HP. It's all on Snacks now in a 1v2 defuse scenario, and he's not going to get it done. Sanks is there to pick up the kill, and Complexity, they end the half in the lead, 8-7. Still a respectable scoreline, still solid work.
Yeah, and Sanks actually being tied for top frags with Neo. They both got 16 kills. Overall, a very, very respectable first half, I think, out of Complexity. Not sure 8 rounds is enough for them to win the game, but you got to consider their opponent as well. Definitely some good stuff. And we just got the camera here on Jason, but he was just clapping and cheering and being very excited. Can't really blame him for that. Complexity, they're certainly going to need to win the pistol round to make this very interesting, but I mean, so far they're showing us a lot more than they did on Overpass. We'll be back after the break. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are going to head into the second half here, the second map between Complexity and Virtus Pro. And it finished 8-7. It wasn't too bad. All right, we get a birthday greeting from Taco. You know, he's just an incredibly friendly person. I don't think I've ever met Taco in an event where he hasn't been in a very good mood and just always happy to talk and very friendly.
Thanks, Taco. Love it, man. Seriously. Well, I mean, we'll be seeing each other next week, right? So see you soon, bro.
That is true. That is true. We have a bit of comparison here. I mean, Neo and Sanx both playing very well. It was Def on the first map who was sort of doing the most for Complexity. So it's encouraging to see that they have different players who could try and step it up and maybe get a chance to show a little bit here. They will need, I think, to win the pistol round in order to have like a real chance at actually doing this. Otherwise, I think it's going to be too much of an uphill battle. Virtus Pro, they have all armor, and that's already a sign that they might be trying to play a little bit aggressively.
I just want to get out there and look for a brawl. Not even a flash to kind of set it up. It's going to be very straightforward work here from Virtus Pro. They do slow down the pace. They aren't going to go straight charging out onto a site. But this is just, you know, kind of a fail-safe scenario.
Oh, no.
Although Pasha and Taz, they've got a bit of a cheeky setup over here in case the flank comes out from Android. Two players stacked up, one on top of the other. And it's almost like you want VP to make some noise over towards B just to bait Android out into the open. And yeah, something must have happened because Android's now starting to charge forward, really trying to look for the info. And Pasha, Taz, they hear his footsteps. So they know this guy's like right around the corner. There it is. But what? Pasha, what? Android with the double kill. They get the drop on him and it completely falls apart for VP.
That's one of the worst things I've seen in a long time, but great reaction coming out of Android. That's a high pressure situation. Like, it's very hard to hit headshots when you're going to be flanked like that. So good job on him. At least Depp is going to be going down. It is still a 2-on-3. Neo moving up, and Whitmer was very low on health already. They're going to get the bomb plant. It's a very good bomb plant out in the open. Surreal going to be taken out by Ali. Neo trapped on the site right now in a 1-on-2. They have a smoke if they wanted to try and force him out into a peak, whoever's defusing. Neo trying to see if he could play with the Glock here. 12 bullets still left. Bomb not that far ticked, and he's being trapped actually. 17 health left out in the open now, trying to see if he can make this work, but Sanx is going to be able to take him down, and that should be a defuse. No problem here for Surreal. Complexity winning a pistol round in spite of what looked like an awful start.
Now we have to see if VP are going to be able to... Oh yeah, wow. So he doesn't even care about Pasha. He takes out Taz before Taz can even get into the fight. First click, boom. That is a sick play from Android.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not even sure if there was any like thought going into that. I think he literally just turned around and said, oh, you know, what's happening?
Muscle memory, right? Just like, well, the natural born killer.
Why
he's actually playing later today, but we got to see something from Android. That's cool.
Yeah, I mean, that play obviously kind of secures the round. I mean, it doesn't quite secure, but it certainly sets them up very nicely. If they don't get that, imagine how badly outplayed you must feel if there are two people waiting for you like that, and they actually get the kill on you.
Now it's like exponentially worse for the two guys on VP, or it's just like, we were two of us, we had the drop on him, and he still wrecked us. Okay, then. A Complexity, man, they aren't messing around either. They go straight to the rifles. Single SMG picked up on Android, but Surreal taking full advantage of the M4, the advantage of range. He will get hunted down by Snacks in the end, kind of caught out in the open there, but he does get that first pick, and Def, not wasting any time, just goes charging out onto the site, looking to get this shotgun into the fight, and he will be able to pick up one kill.
Very good job, Taz, the last man left here. He's got the time, but he doesn't have any armor, so it should be no issue, and indeed, it will be a team ace coming out every single member. Picking up one kill each. That'll put us at 10-7, a three-round lead for Complexity. And Virtus Pro, they have rifles this time around. We'll see if they can have an impact on the early stages of the second half here. Always feels good if you're on the T side to get that early round in.
Oh, absolutely. You want, and especially because that's really going to wreck Complexity's money. So that's the whole bit. You don't want it to have that big round 5 rounds in, because then Complexity is just like, right, okay, we'll just buy up double ops or something now off all the money that we've made in the first few rounds. Instead, it's going to be Whitmer going ultra aggressive. He catches Pasha out, and that was between Surreal and Whitmer. They had a bit of a pincer play there. Clever stuff coming out from Complexity, but Taz is going to turn it around. He gets two kills to bring it back, and a third one comes in from Bialy.
Yeah, and I feel like Whitmer was sort of very, very far committed to doing that. I'm not sure how far into that run he got the kill, but he seemed to keep going, which may have been a little bit too much. Surreal moving up in a very good position. That's a bomb down. Sprays. Oh, he almost gets by Ali. If he could have got that kill, it would have been beautiful. Still now should be around here for VP. Sanx is coming in from behind and he's got 18 kills, but I'm not sure if he can get another three in this round. And holding close is Neo, and that will be the round. So 10-8.
Man, he was way out there, but I mean, that was just clever angle use there from Taz. The fact that he was using the pillar there, the wall basically, to block himself off from long, it means that the other half of that push from Complexity couldn't actually find a target. Taz was able to just take a series of duels, which is exactly what he's hoping for in that scenario. Damn, he's even got a new hat. You notice that?
Yeah. I mean, he's definitely looking all swagged out.
Still, it's little details, Anders, you know? Little details. It's all about. Just like in CS. But Complexity, now it is that worst case scenario that we talked about. Now back to pistols.
Yeah, holding middle here. A little bit of a double setup. The rest over at B. So none of that really creative stuff that we were seeing on Overpass, where they were trying with the flashbang and they were sort of being a bit aggressive, which I still think you could do on this map. In fact, there are quite a few places you could do it on this map where you could sort of stack up so you're out of sight. And when the first person engages someone, that's when you pop out the flash and everyone goes. Think about this A bomb site, how many places you could hide CTs in where it'd be very hard to find them, and then, you know, first engagement, everyone is there.
I'm a little flabbergasted there just because Pasha was literally able to stand out in the open facing towards Underpass, and yet there were two players for Complexity on the site. He was able to survive for quite some time. I mean, he obviously survives the round, but thought that we'd get shot in the back there by one of the flankers. So it doesn't really pan out nicely for Complexity in this round. Even just, I mean, Def can't catch a break. They don't know that he's there. It's just Pasha putting random shots through the wooden wall, and he walks into half of them. So he's down to 44 HP without even having seen anybody.
It's upsetting.
A little frustrating, yeah.
No one likes that. That's twice now that Neo is planted in that forward position, and I've been making a lot of noise in the past about that. I just generally am not a fan of default plants, unless there's a good reason for it. That plant right there is one that I have a couple of plans for myself in some future videos. But there's, I think in a lot of ways it's a superior place to plant, and there are, and if you think about the after plant scenario for that bomb plant, it's so much better than if you go for the default.
Right.
So yeah, interested to see if Virtus Pro are gonna try and use some of that later. Good shot from Taz, and obviously they don't have armor, they only have some pistols here as well on Complexity, so can't expect too much, but be nice if they could pick up maybe steal an AK somewhere.
Well, this is just a little frustrating for Complexity. They keep turning away and then just free kills. Android not gonna get any joy there. Snacks patiently holding against the smoke is gonna be able to pick him off for free. And that leaves Surreal rotating over towards the from the A site. This was a stack as well from Complexity. Well, I mean, they had four players there, so it's basically as tough a defense as it can get unless the fifth man who's playing A rotates over. But still, I mean, Complexity tried to give themselves the best chance at actually having an impact in that round, and it just doesn't pan out whatsoever.
You see that? By Ali, he initiated the fist bumps, and they sort of went all down the line. No one broke the chain of fist bumps.
It's like the wave. This is how the players do it.
Interesting. I like that.
Well, you know, Flamey isn't here this week, right? And the camera angle, right, with Flamey was always a little confusing. Did he actually return Caesar's high five or not?
I mean, I would absolutely put time into practicing high fives or fist bumps if I was in the team. Might not be the best use of time, but it would look incredible on camera, I'm sure.
Or you're just a natural talent like Flush and JW, right? Don't crush your teammates' fingers.
Very careful indeed. There's four people stacked up right here, and they can certainly hear them jumping down into drop depth. It's going to be picking up the one kill there, but he is traded, and Android so close to catching Taz, but he made just enough noise that he's going to be able to make it out, and Pasha with the grenade kill, and even Taz picking up Sanx there, so it's still a 2-on-2. The bomb is making its way up, and it should be successful. Molotov in both the entrances there, Pasha going to make his way over.
Yeah, and it's going to be more of an open plant out in the open, just using the hut to cover himself there. But that is a pretty wide plant in the middle of the plateau. And so we'll see if they're actually going to be able to pull this off. Pasha's about to get toasty for him. He's got to have to change up his position. Just decides to charge forward, take the fight with Android, and he wins it. And now it's all on Whitmer coming in from connector angle. But both players for Virtus Pro, they've got them. He's in a bit of a tight spot right now. If he peeks one, the other's going to be able to get the trade frag. So he needs to count on somebody on VP's side making the mistake of stepping out into the open right now, and nobody from VP is going to give him that kind of chance. They're just perfectly content to sit on the site and wait. Very well done here by VP in the end, and that's going to put them in the lead 11-10. At least he gets the parting shot.
Yeah, a little bit going his way, but ultimately VP's economy is a lot better. Look at the amount of money they have. Look at this all the way down the line. Good stuff.
Nope.
Oh, they it ended.
Denied.
Neo breaking a chain.
No, no. Neo got snacks.
Oh,
Pasha. Calling out Pasha, man.
I don't think Neo tried it, though, did he? I think he stopped it.
Yeah, it did look like he stopped it. Maybe there was like he felt like Pasha was just not going to return it. So he, instead of leaving himself hanging, just decided to cut it off there.
That's a real shame.
Enough gifts of that on Reddit right now. Don't need to add any more.
True, true. Yeah, so the money right now for Virtus Pro is at a point where Complexity need to win consecutive rounds. And worse still, their own economy is so bad that they don't have any tools to do it with. So in a round like this, I feel like just in the interest of keeping the money low on the Polish side, they need to get a couple of kills. They need to get preferably 2 or 3 just to make sure that VP don't run away with the economic game here. Android going down. Depp a little bit out in the open, but a really good shot and Surreal helping out. There's 2 kills, 1 more would be golden, and Def is actually going to find it on by Ali. I have no idea how, but it does work out. Sank's now the last man left in a 1-on-2. It's a great round for Complexity. I mean, this is exactly the kind of stuff they need. The only downside is they did let go of the AWP.
Yeesh, this plant is actually planting for Sank's. Snacks, Sank's going up against each other. Snacks is going to make use of the stairs to look up onto Plateau, so Sank's about to walk right into it, hits the shot, but he gets dropped down to 19 HP, and this should be a perfect situation now for Taz. Although Sank's has found an AWP to work with, he's looking for the wallbang on Chicken Coop, not going to find him there. Instead, Taz, I mean, the bomb isn't necessarily planted for Taz, it's not excellent, but if Taz hears the defuse, he's going to be able to go for it. Sank's nearly hits the wallbang, and he's going to go back for the peek, he sees it coming, and he gets the clutch!
Wow,
beautiful work.
That's actually an insane 1v2. You gotta consider the fact that he had just a pistol and no kit, no grenades or anything. Very impressive. Sank's is playing a pretty good game right now. Currently at 20 kills, still tied with Neo, who's also at 20. So that's also gonna tie up the scoreline at 11-11. Very, very good job right now. We do have one guy briefly disconnecting from the game, so he'll be back in, obviously.
Yeah.
But, I mean, sort of win or lose right now. I feel like Complexity have shown us quite a bit.
He should be back in any moment now. That's one thing to pick up on this so far. I mean, actually, Complexity, the rounds that they've been winning some key rounds, and they've been winning anti-eco rounds, basically. When they're sitting on pistols, we saw it in the first half on the second round where they just charged onto the B side with the Tech-9s. But here again, in a key round, VP give it up to Complexity with like a bunch of 5-7s, basically. And again, Def. I mean, he is a little bit quieter than he was on Overpass, but still, he's had a couple of rounds now when he's on the CT side. He just seems to be in position to at least get 1 kill. This time he went above and beyond in this last round, getting the second one on Bialy. But Def has been definitely doing quite a lot of work there.
Warden trying to see if maybe he could talk his teammates into a victory here. Right now, it seems like they're on the right track. I mean, they've won 2 rounds consecutively. If they could pick up another one here, money would actually still be there for VP. That's the downside. They kind of need to just keep stringing rounds together, because if they crumble now, VP are going to win, if nothing else, just as a function of the economy. Just because Complexity won't have enough rifles to keep buying. That's one of the worst ways of losing a game, I feel like.
This is almost like an opposite style game as well. VP again going to be just looking to get out onto this A site. Smoke goes down from Surreal to block off A long. So he's able to look into the lower underpass and he picks up the kill on Bialy, who's playing solo. Now Neo trying to lead the way here to bring it back for his team. And he will get caught by Def. And the rotation is now coming in here for Complexity. They should be able to keep a lid on things. They still have the man advantage. And Def kind of dancing around on the edge of the murder hole there, not willing to commit through. Instead, waiting for that bomb to get planted.
I feel like Surreal could have probably just waited a little bit. They didn't know that he was there. He had some backup coming in. I think he was a little bit nervous, a little bit anxious. And those are some of the nerves that sort of come into play, right? When you're a little bit inexperienced. 4 versus 3. They are trying to see if they can make their way through, but a counter boost coming up, and Sank's going to be going down. Virtus Pro reading the situation very well indeed. And Snax picking up a kill, double for Pasha right now. And Android trying to sneak in, see if he can clutch it. He does actually see the shadow, I think, before anything else. He's got the kit, trying to see if he can hold it down. Pasha sneaking on in, and he's going to be able to get the kill. Triple for Pasha, and that will be Virtus Pro picking up another round. And Complexity, I mean, close round, down to 1v1.
Brutal. Brutal round, because it looked so good there, actually. VP, again, with the hero play, Pasha getting boosted up. That was the big difference maker. But VP right now, I mean, they're doing a good job of throwing Complexity for a loop. Because they keep, I think Complexity, in this round, they had four players initially over towards B. They started rotating back, but I think the Complexity are just like, okay, when are they actually going to really start hitting B on us? And VP just keeps saying, well, we're actually much more interested in the A site right now. And so there is a lot of pressure put on Surreal to really just hold the line. That, I like the peak at the underpass, the way it started out. It was a solid start for Complexity. It's just keeping a lid on things. VP still. It is once again back to pistols, and VP, they get that feel-good moment, the anti-eco. Although it's turned sour a couple times so far. They should be able to keep it under control here, considering they have a two-man advantage.
Yeah, but part of the problem is a lot of the rounds the VP are winning are ones where they have a lot of members alive. It's been down to sort of 1v1 a couple of times, but mainly it's been 4 or 5 members surviving, and that means the economy just gets so out of control. Pasha starting this round at plus 11,000, so...
Taz just looks like the annoyed dad, where he's just like, is this my son? Weak, weak. And I'm trying to go for the fist bump. It's just like this like weak thing that's coming at him, like a fish handshake from Bialy.
Yeah, but as you said, you got to be careful, right? Can't be fist bumping too hard. Get those fingers broken. Whitmer, Sanx, and Android holding the B bomb site, and they're going to need to hold it very well because there's a whole rush from Virtus Pro coming in. It will be Sanx and Android going down. Whitmer trying to stay alive, but failing. Snax with a double kill in return. Surreal and Def are left, and I mean, there's not even any point in even entertaining the notion. Skip it up. Abandon all hope.
Now bail on the sinking ship. Because that's going to put a VP up onto 14 rounds now. And VP, man, first time that they've gone for the full out straight YOLO rush onto that B site, and it just completely wrecks Complexity. They were caught unprepared there. They had nades in their hands. They were just trying to make something happen on the Complexity side, because they're just like, wait, but we have all the nades to throw out and actually stop this from happening. And VP just never really gave them a chance. Single smoke, single HE, that's all Complexity got out before VP were on the site. So now, I mean, VP, just such a tough team to handle, because they always have so much variety on their T side. They're constantly shifting it up. And so Complexity, they can't really just figure out a pattern. Boom, there's a shot. Nice one there from Surreal. Takes down Pasha, so he makes it a little bit more expensive, but look at how quick they are. Well, this, like, Snax is finding this kill on the man and drop, but Taz is already on the bomb site, wrapping on the two guys holding by connector. So it's just, where do Complexity go? They've completely lost control of the situation by then.
We've got 3 members of VP on 20 kills, then 1 on 18, 1 on 16. Has it ever happened similar that a team ended up with the exact same amount of kills at the end of a game? I don't think I've ever seen that.
I don't think we've ever seen that, no.
That seems like statistically as well, it'd be hard to reach. We may have a shot at it here if it keeps going like this. Neo going to be pushing in again. It's a very, very quick pace coming out, and you can see he's catching them off guard here. Surreal does get a refrag in, but Snax is on the hunt, and it will be down to Def in a 1-on-4, and he goes down. That will make it 15 rounds for Virtus Pro, and again, that speed is just too much for them to handle. You'd think they'd be able to throw out a couple of grenades to slow it down, but that hasn't been happening.
It's total obliteration. They get the Molotov down, but like VP are just like, right, well, just run through the Molotov, because Neo's already so deep in. And the flank coming in towards connector as well. It's just so brutal. That's what is so difficult. That's why nades are so important for the CT side on that B side. You need to just constantly bombard plateau to stop that kind of rush from coming in. Because as soon as you lose one man on that B side, it's so difficult to hold. It's so easy to get the terrorists, you know, to actually get that clamp, that flank onto the site and just crush the defense. Now VP is just saying, oh, okay, well, we played ultra aggressive on B. Now we're just going to go and rush A. That's fine. And it works.
Snax is even waiting for Surreal here. That's so smart, just as a way to make sure that no one's going to be sneaking up behind. Bialy catching that kill on Whitmer. Mid-air, and it looks like this will be the end of the line, but an infinitely better scenario here, I think, for Complexity than it was on Overpass, where they definitely struggled a lot. And I mean, even the rounds they got on the second half, you got to think, Not necessarily VP slowing down too much, but just some questionable rounds coming out. It will be Def going down. Headshot from Snacks. There's 16-11 as Virtus Pro do take the second map. We've got to see a lot more out of Complexity and a little bit of an interesting matchup on Cobblestone here.
And this, you know, Complexity, they can't really beat themselves up too much, I think, with the loss. What they can be proud of is, like, they did actually get a respectable scoreline here going onto the second map. 11 rounds against Virtus Pro on Cobblestone. It's solid work. And when you think about how these groups pan out in the situation where you're going to have ties between the different teams in the groups, rounds make a difference. And so you didn't get steamrolled. You actually did get a respectable scoreline. So that could make the difference for them deeper into the groups here. But it looks like we will be throwing it over pretty soon to the analyst desk for them to go ahead and break down the action here on this second map between Virtus Pro and Complexity. But first, it's time for a quick commercial break. So we'll be right back.